Now, if sample size is same, we have an option of using simple t-test instead of going in such a complex. If sample size is same, we can take the difference of the sample, because it is the same thing, pre-treatment and post-treatment, we take the difference of the variability, difference of the values, and that difference can be tested whether that difference is zero or not. So that method is called as pairwise t-test. Example of pairwise t-test I will take right now. It will become very much similar to the simple t-test hypothesis testing. So let's see. In this case, taxi company is trying to decide whether the use of radial tire instead of regular belted tire improves fuel efficiency. There are two types of tires, radial and both. Without changing driver, the same cars were then equipped with the new tire. The same thing tested with intervention of belted tires. Now they want to see whether the car equipped with radial tire gives better fuel economy than those equipped with belted tire. You have to use value hypothesis. But sample size is same in both the cases. What we can do is we can create a table for the difference. We create a table for the difference. Be a table 0.1 minus 0.2, then 0.4, and so on. We can create this table, and this will become our x parameter. And that x can be tested against mu. Whether this x is mu or not, whether this sample belongs to source or not. In this case, we have to see whether the mu is 0 or mu is more than 0. Then we are subtracting performance of 1. We are subtracting performance of second belted tire from performance of radial tire. Let's see how it goes, because it becomes a very simple t-test. We call it pairwise t-test. In our null hypothesis, is mu. In our alternate hypothesis, this difference is more than zero, because we have to test the claim that radial tire is making with respect to the belted tire. If it is more, obviously we will apply alternate hypothesis of this case. But we will not compare the t value, rather we will compare t value. In this case, we will compare t value with respect to alpha. We have to assume, in this case we can assume alpha as 0.05, because 0.05 is a kind of thumb rule. Pairwise t-test is very simple, and we can only apply when the sample size is same. This ST becomes standard deviation of the difference. Of the difference, we can calculate the mean. Of the difference, we can calculate the variance. So D naught is the mean of samples, difference, and SD is the standard deviation of the samples difference. Now this difference, that will be this minus this. We can apply this over the whole range. We apply this, we can calculate the mean, average of all this will be here, and we can calculate the standard deviation, that will standard deviation of all this will be here. Now if we see this, we have a bold values, numbers 0.14 and 0.20. In our case, null hypothesis is that this difference mean must be equal to 0, or alternate hypothesis, this difference mean more than, that is the claim gross variance is not known, sigma square is unknown, we will apply. Then we will apply t distribution, we will calculate the value of t. T is nothing but t minus t naught upon st upon square root of n. N is same here, 1, 2, and d naught is 0 in our case. St is 0.20 upon square root of, that will come out as 2.49. For nu is 12 minus 1, this is 11. Transforming to t distribution, this is at the value of nu as 11 in 0. Is an axis. Now we have to see whether the difference is same or difference is more. So if difference is more, our critical region will be the right side. This will be our critical region. And level of significance, if I assume as alpha 0.05, then this will be our critical zone, and this is our confidence interval, that will be equal to 1.95, all as acceptance side of the region. So this point will be our critical value of t, which will be t alpha at the value of t 0.0. Now what is t calculated? T calculated is 2.49. This value see from table of the distribution 11, the value is 1.796 will be the value. So this is 796. What will be the decision here? Criteria T calculated is more than this, t calculated goes here. So this will be the point t calculated. This will be called as t value. T calculated is more than t alpha, means h naught is rejected. Now if the decision is to be taken based on this t value, then we have to pick up t value from table. For degrees of freedom 11, the row is this. The value of alpha with respect to 2.49 is approximately 0.015. That will be called as our t value. So t will be 0.015 with respect to t 2.4. T is 0.015, which is far less than alpha, that is 0.05. Means H naught is rejected. So your radial size is significant higher mileage than belted tires. So these were the maximum possible procedures for using T test or Z test for hypothesis testing based on. In the coming lectures, we will compare, we will take the situations where variances plays important role, the variability plays an important role. We will perform hypothesis testing based on variance, which may be further useful in OI analysis. So those hypothesis testing by variance will depend upon either chi-square test or F test. Till then, enjoy the learning of hypothesis testing by me. Thank you very much.